We had a storm which had a tremendous amount of energy. It left us without power, including many of our neighbors, for 7 straight days. And it's a reminder that we're so close to living in a third world country environment. I mean, not having electricity for 7 days makes it obviously very, very difficult. The house begins to smell. It becomes difficult to sleep. I mean, it's not so bad in the sense that you do have water sometimes. But even so, it makes you think very intently that if some massive type of destruction were done, or not even massive, if it was just if the electrical grid went down in this country, you could see the end result, and it wouldn't be good. And there's really not all that much that our government could do for us. We know just with our local government, they couldn't do anything. You'd use your cell phone to call the electric company. They didn't know when our lines were going to be corrected. You just had to be at the mercy of the conditions. And of course, some people had generators, and that's a big help. But you know, how long would that last if there were a real great problem? So again, we tend to think we're safe from the conditions, but in reality, we really aren't that far from, ever far from, third world status. Some other notes: the storm that hit had 60 mile an hour winds consistently for about a half an hour. Then after that, we had 80 mile an hour winds for a few minutes, and those winds more or less did the destruction. We have a lot of trees around here, so we went down the base, my wife and I, and it was scary, to be honest. Yeah, I mean, trees not the best way to go, so to speak. I mean, just look at these, they're like massive batons that could smash your head like a pumpkin. And believe me, these things were swaying at 45 degrees that night. And if you lived around here, you'd see that, for example, these high wires here, many, many people had trees taking them down, branches coming off into them, and you could go for 25 miles and see the same thing. So you basically had 200,000 people without electricity. Now, while that's a large number, if you could imagine areas of high density, you know, if it had been Philadelphia or New York, you wonder with people in such proximity what would have happened. I mean, we're out here in an area where there are a lot of people. So in essence, you're not too worried about any type of looting or violence, although we do live close to the hood. But in general, no major problems in that sense. But it wouldn't take much in other areas. And it makes me remember Katrina and how those people, you know, were on top of the roofs asking for help. And at some point, you just wonder, you know, is that it? Because they're not there, and they don't come. They don't come. But I've kind of been through this before in a relative way, not quite as long as a week. And you know, you get resilient after a while to it. I mean, my wife and I survived it, but it makes you think.